Welcome back to Bama 21. What a night it's been, and we've still got one more match left for you. It's Harry Marple versus Sergei Bilder.
So, Chris, Medea from France, you really feel has got a tough call here with... Look how cool he looks, young, dirty Harry Marple.
And the Parisian has definitely got his work cut out for him in taking on Dirty Harry, but... Yeah, watch out for that left head kick from Harry. It's very deceptive. He uses that very nicely. It's a very quick attack.
So why did you think that Bedia will need to stick to Harry like glue?
I think it's because of A, the reach advantage, B, the mobility and speed advantage, and C, the fact that if he ends up on top, Harry will be active off his back.
As you said, there's that speed and mobility, those knees already looking to trouble Bedia. Oh, nice head movement, but Bedia coming back strongly.
And those punches landing flush for Harry, but showing good patience, not getting completely flustered here. Look at the way he hits that switch on him. That is textbook right there. Prevents the takedown, right back up to his feet. Outstanding counter wrestling from Harry.
But I must say, your prediction of how Bedia would fight is spot on.
And the Frenchman trying to find the distance. And Harry doing a nice job setting up things off that lead jab.
You just get the feeling that Medea really doesn't want to be at this range, does he?
Yeah, Medea's got to be real careful to not get lulled into Harry being able to dictate where the action happens. As I said, Bedia would be wise to probably try to cut the distance and get in close. Maybe more importantly, cut off the cage, work the geometry, narrow the angles.
But look what he risked! Oh! I was just about to say, look what he risked! What? He risked the knee, Chris, and it landed. Look at that.
Unbelievable. Harry, what a finish with a textbook right knee, cranking home to the chin of his opponent. The Frenchman falls and is still dazed. Wow, what a finish.
Chris, that's the danger when you try to close the gap with the taller man, isn't it? That is the danger you risk every single time.
And Harry is playing laser precision with that technique and showing off why he started training MMA first. Let's take a look at the replay here. And you can see the way he cranked him with a couple of nice straight shots and a right uppercut. And a good couple of knees, but the second one being the real banger, landing flush, and then he put him away. What a sensational striking setup from Dirty Harry Marple. We'll get another angle on that one right here, and you can see the way he controlled that plunk. Real tight, elbows tight, able to whip around the posture, and more importantly, create the optimum velocity and angle to land that strike. Brilliant stuff. And we'll give ourselves just a moment here to allow him to recover. Safe MMA being one of the key sponsors here at Bama. And as our referee in charge assesses the situation, we will go over to our MC, Mr. Buddy Johnson, to give us the official announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout ended 1 minute 23 seconds of the first round. Your winner by knockout in the blue corner, Dirty Harry Marple!
So let's look at the tail of the tape. 31, the younger man, Godbeer. Look at that height advantage, 6'4" to 5'10". Then look at the two records. These men bang them out. I can't wait for this one. So let's get this on with our master of ceremonies, Buddy Johnson.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the co-main event of the evening. When the action begins.
Well, gentlemen, you understand the rules you're fighting under. You listen to it all times, keep yourself protected. When I say stop, you stop. If you want to touch gloves, do it now. Let's do this.
So, Chris, the atmosphere has just gone through the roof here. Huge support for both men. Both, everybody knows, carries genuinely explosive power. You just can't see this one going out the first round.
Mark the hand of Godbeer and Paul the Titan Taylor. It is electric in here. I can barely hear myself, let alone you. I've got goosebumps, Malcolm.
Well, the thing here for me, going back to a classic matchup, especially with the haymaker David Hay here. This is, for me, Lennox Lewis versus Mike Tyson. Can the Lennox Lewis of our fight, Mark Godbeer, keep the Mike Tyson of our fight, Paul Taylor, away at range, or can Taylor get inside like with the explosive power of Tyson?
And Godbeer doing just that now with some good footwork. A little tentative, a little bit of a feeling out process here, and a nice right round kick a moment ago landed.
So for me, it's all about range tonight, Chris.
Without a doubt, and if you look at all of Taylor's wins in his history, I am waiting for the moment for the powder keg to ignite. He will blitz in and quite literally create the perfect storm.
Well, I was talking to Godbeer's coach Arthur Meek, and he said they've brought in sparring partners of his height and his power. Godbeer knows the way that Taylor works, and they've been drilling into him not to let him get into that range.
Yeah, and speaking of Paul Taylor, I mean, he's been over at American Kickboxing Academy there, training with some of the very best heavyweights in the world. Taylor is a gifted athlete, but just ate another big right round kick, Malcolm.
Yes, and you can see Godbeer wants to keep that range. He wants to keep that distance. As soon as Taylor looked to come in, Godbeer moved. And he's being very patient. We're used to seeing him come in, all guns blazing, showing Taylor huge respect here.
And I felt that the kicking game was going to be a very defining strategy for Godbeer tonight, but that right hand from Taylor is a missile, homing in on the target of Godbeer's chin. Another right round kick for Godbeer, very solid. In and out, that's exactly what he needs to do.
Well, Chris, you know what he's doing. He's saying, if this man comes forward deceptively fast, let's take those legs away to stop him doing that.
And more importantly, occupy center ring, where he cannot get backed up against the cage. That's where Godbeer generally would not want to be, because that's where Taylor makes his best business.
Yes, so Godbeer chopping at the legs of Taylor, trying to stop that explosive power by stopping the legs that propel it.
And you'll notice the way Godbeer is kind of moving in and out and responding to Taylor's footwork.
I'd just like to see him moving either way, away from that explosive right hand. He's moving towards it in a clockwise manner. He needs to start moving anti-clockwise away from Taylor.
Yeah, he's doing that to try to line up that right round kick. As you said, it is dangerous territory when you consider the fact that Taylor has scored most of his significant fight-ending shots with the right hand, so... Nice inside leg kick. That one really cracked home on Paul Taylor.
It makes perfect sense, Chris.
And you could say the way that his weight shifted from the impact of the thud.
Oh, the big row! Taylor took it, but it pushed him back, and you can hear the West Country fans going there. The first meaningful blow is to Godbeer, and he follows it up again. And Taylor looks at him almost like with disdain, Chris.
Totally. Mark Godbeer showing off some good maturity and patience here, though, in this bout. He knows he tagged Taylor, but doesn't want to get too over-anxious with his assault.
And again, you see, he wants that range kept at a certain level. They've drilled this. He does not want to be in close with Taylor, and he set his stall out early. And at the moment, with just over 1.5 minutes left, it's Godbeer's round through his technique and his tactics.
Nice left hook from Taylor. We're going to get a little moment here to pull that excess tape off. And we're back underway. Good touch of gloves.
Yes, Godbeer has remained very focused with 1.5 minutes to go. He's not allowed Taylor any chance to use his God-given power.
Godbeer was very passionate about his training and preparation and coming into this fight, and he's really ticking all the boxes, moving down the checklist of his really, I guess, surgical pinpoint striking so far. He's not getting lured into Paul's territory where really a firefight could erupt that could go against him.
And poor Taylor will have to start checking these legs. Oh, beautiful movement there from Godbeer when the big right hand came, but he's going to have to start checking those kicks as well, Chris.
Yeah, tremendous performance so far from Mark Godbeer. 4 minutes in, and Paul Taylor really not able to usher any offense, but the crowd just chanting in this arena, Malcolm.
Yeah, so it's really raising that. And it's Taylor's fans that obviously are a bit worried here, that are really trying to get behind their man and inspire him. But at the moment, the inspiration is all coming from Godbeer.
And Taylor looks pretty calm, pretty collected still. He's not getting fazed by this, but those leg kicks are cracking home. Nice check there, though. That was much better.
Chris, he's got the equalizer. Remember, he can stay calm. He knows he's stopped all 9 of his opponents dead. When you carry that equalizing power, you can remain patient.
Without a doubt, and Taylor will look to return fire when it suits him best. Thus far, though, the dominating factor has been Godbeer's precision and, most importantly, movement in avoiding the power of Taylor.
Oh, he's kept the range perfectly. It's been a textbook opening round. As we come inside the last 10 seconds, it's a big opening round to Godbeer.
And Godbeer breathing a little bit there, but staying pretty calm throughout the round. And Taylor with a little bit of a look of frustration, he moves away to his corner, Malcolm.
So, Chris, this is Godfear at his most focused. And those leg kicks will take their toll on an explosive fighter trying to close the gap. And we saw it there, Chris. It's a great tactic.
And that is just perfect technique, the way he opens up his hip, steps in for that right hand as well. I really like the disciplined approach of Mark Godfear. It's very impressive to see. Coming into a very dangerous fight, and you know, Taylor got his hands down. Probably a little bit frustrated, more importantly, a little bit flustered from the impact of those kicks, Malcolm.
Yes, and there is Mark Godfear, a great opening round for this young man. He feels this is destiny now, he really wants to step up. And we felt this could be a real first round finish. It hasn't proven, so it's been more technical, more time consuming as he picks his shots. What can Taylor bring back? And Chris, you can see the mark on the midsection of Taylor from the round kick of Godfear.
Yeah, his lead leg is really, for those that can't see it, as red as a tomato. And he's been placed into early adversity by Godfear.
And again, Chris, when you think about it, what an arena for them. We've heard the crowd. It's a full house here at the Barclaycard Arena for Bama 21. And a lot of that full house is fans of these two big men.
Yeah, you can totally hear it. Every time a leg kick lands, every time Taylor moves forward, there's a lot of support in here for each fighter as they unload their barrage. Big heavyweight title on the line tonight. Bama's first ever champion. Bama 21 setting records. Making things happen here in Birmingham Barclay Arena tonight.
And you saw Godfear literally push Taylor away to say that gap is not being closed. What excites me though, Chris, is one lack of concentration, one change in focus, and no matter how much you've done well beforehand, it can all be academic.
And the way that Taylor emphasizes that ducking head movement, he's looking to try and fake a shot, but in reality, he has Godfear's face in his sights with a big right hand. So this could all change in an instant. Nice check from Taylor. It's much better now.
Yes, he's going to have to check, but Godfear closes the gap when he feels like it steps out very quickly. So Taylor has also got timing issues now. He knows to land that right where he needs to be. Godfear is never very long in that space.
And Mark Godfear looking to keep his title run coming here with a successful game plan. He's really set back Taylor, I think, so far. Taylor's got his hands down. You know, he looks calm, looks collected, but I think it's been a blistering pace by Godfear so far.
And again, he just clips with that right hand as Taylor ducks. You wonder when the right hand overhand reply from Taylor will come, because at the moment, he's been lured into Mark Godfear's game plan.
Yeah, you can see the intent. There we go, see what I mean?
That and big, he's limping now. For the first time, he limped from that shot.
I was going to say, that big left hook shows exactly what he's looking for, but you know, it's a big fight for Taylor. He's coming here tonight, a Bama newcomer against a guy who's 2-0. So that might be a little bit of a factor as we continue on into round two here, Malcolm.
But also, Chris, watch Taylor's legs, the way he switches. He's trying to now protect that left leg. He switches quite constantly because that left leg is now in real danger.
A wise decision. I'd like to see him do that a little bit more often, but actually do it and land punches. You hear the crowd cheer as he comes forward. There's a lot
of
support.
The uppercut, though, from Taylor, the first one.
That was what I was saying. There's a big build-up in the way he's looking to try and land that. And it definitely unsettled Godfear. You can see the way Godfear moves away.
And he's got to keep chopping at that leg because Taylor will find it harder and harder to come forward to tee off that big right hand.
Ooh, that was
Godfear
a big one.
Keeps at those legs.
Yeah, I was going to say that right kick landed real nice, and so did that right cross.
And the left hook from Godfear as well. Doing it on the top of the head. Luckily, Taylor ducked the head at the last second there.
Just excellent technique from Godfear. Really showing off why he has the hands of a divine being here tonight. And he's really addressed a lot of the holes in his defense. You know, Taylor has not been able to find a way in. That's a scary dude to be in with the cage for 15 minutes.
That's the only place Godfear doesn't want to be. I know he landed the knee, but that is the only danger zone for him here. And again, the right lands, the to the head as well. The double got the roundhouse and then the big knee.
Oh my
Taylor,
goodness.
Taylor, that bleeding, calls him on. That's what Taylor wants. What? He needs Godfear to get him carried away.
What a fight, ladies and gentlemen. We've got a big one happening here.
Oh, another knee, Chris.
Oh, wow. Paul Taylor is a tough customer. That guy has a chin as hard as granite.
But Chris, Godfear can't get carried away, even when he's backed up like that. That's where Taylor wants him. He wants Godfear to get complacent, get in to finish the job. Then he's in range. At the moment, Taylor has just not had the range that he wants here.
As the blood streams down Paul Taylor's face, he's got a look of determination in his eyes moving this last minute, Malcolm. I think he's got to make something happen, or he's going to have to finish it come round three.
Let's talk about round three. Who thought it would have gone round one, let alone round two? And it's the patience and discipline of Godfrey. Oh, and there's the knee again! Oh. What has Taylor made of?
Wow!
He's just walking forward, he's just taken three knees!
Jarring knees!
Now Godfrey turns with the right hands as well, but this is what Taylor wants. How's that man still stood there, Chris?
I can't believe it! This guy has taken punishment to the nth degree here, and just dips his chin and keeps waltzing forward.
Unbelievable stuff here. Godbeer has hit him with knees, right hands. All he needs is to tear up the kitchen sink and throw it at him, and he's still there. He's saying it's all over! It's all over!
Oh!
Goddard has looked at his face. He doesn't like what he's seen. And Godbeer is the champion.
Godbeer.
He's the heavyweight champion. What a performance from Mark Godbeer. Taylor, have you ever seen anyone so tough? And yet, the referee said, I have seen enough.
Unbelievable. Godbeer literally screaming to us here at commentary position. I'm back. I am back. Pointing a finger. 3-0. Paul Taylor went after him with all of the fire he could muster. But it just was not enough, Malcolm.
Well, Mark Godbeer is now the heavyweight champion. And what a performance to do it.
And we'll take a look at the replay here of that fight-ending performance. You can see that right round kick was his bread and butter throughout. And it really cut down Paul Taylor's movements.
And then the left, and he doubles it up here, Chris, for the face as well. How is Taylor still there?
And a completely flush connection. Cracks home with that left high kick from Godbeer. But here we go, this is the end of the fight right now. And you'll see this big knee.
Oh. Totally
elevates Paul Taylor, lifts his feet off the ground. Wow.
And look, he takes it though, Chris. Don't forget the referee stopped it with Chris, with the kicks and the punches.
Man, what a performance from Mark Godbeer. Ladies and gentlemen, the future of the heavyweight division has arrived with your new Bama heavyweight champion.
Unbelievable stuff here, and you can see what it means to Mark Godbeer.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are in the 21st century. Now is the time. Now is the best time to be a martial arts champion. And these two guys coming in here, unbelievable fight. Now is the best reason to be why.
This round ended 4 minutes 47 seconds of the second round. Your winner by TKO, and Nu!